all you scared to death Negroes.
Just sit down. Don't you come out
to defend our enemy. You sit down and you shut up and tell your master to come on out and deal with this.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you didn't know, now you know. We do things differently on this podcast.
Hey, yo, we're going to keep y'all on your toes.
Always.
Different intros. If that don't touch the soul, come on, man.
Perfect. If that don't make the hair stand up on the back of your neck, I don't know what to tell you.
You hear that beat?
Did you hear that intro? That's powerful.
Excuse me.
It's okay.
Got you choked up, bro.
Right. All right. But ladies and gentlemen, we back. It's your boy's Silverback Chronicles podcast. Your boy Big H. My brother Dre.
What it is?
What's good, bro?
How are you?
Hey, yo, I'm well. I can't complain. I'm just enjoying life, bro.
Grinding.
You know the grind. You listen, this grind season every day of the year.
I love grinding now even more because the world is so crazy. I could just keep my head down and just keep trucking away.
That's it. Keep the head low and just getting it.
Shout out to Truck, by the way.
Pop Dukes, get up there. Shut up, baby. Yeah. Triple C.
Yo.
What's good, bro?
Maintaining and chilling, bro.
My man, that's all we do.
That's it.
That's all we do. Let's get into it. I want to give a shout out to our sponsor, Starbucks USA, ladies and gentlemen.
You saw that rifle lock they got now?
You explained that last week, but they got different colors, too.
Ooh, it's like a metallic shiny. I love
fire.
It. They're doing their thing, man. Beautiful, beautiful company. Beautiful guys over there.
Awesome partnership.
Yeah.
Appreciate y'all. Ladies and gentlemen, listen. Go get that, baby. You got an AR? Go get that. You got a handgun pistol? Go get that.
You got a Rolex? Go get it.
Go get it.
Keep that watching then. Why not?
Why not? And don't forget about the discount, 20%. All caps, Silverback Podcast. All caps, Silverback Podcast.
And if wifey got a gun, she got it. She could get a box in pink.
Right.
That's it.
AKA Fuchsia.
That's what it's called?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I like it though.
Fuchsia.
And that's about it. Give a shout out to my boys, fourth quarter. Something got a little emotional. My boy Chim, I'm sorry, bro. Rod, I'm sorry. I forgot your names. I didn't do it on purpose. Love is love. You already know how I operate. But Red Sal, DB, I already said Chim is a
couple of those guys, man. No homo. They look good in those t-shirts.
Yo, everybody.
And the hats,
you know
too.
What I mean?
We appreciate y'all.
We appreciate y'all.
Hey, we got black, navy shirts,
yes.
Hoodies, and matching trucker hats.
It's about to be crazy.
Come on, man. Who said first responders can't be fly?
And look sexy. And look, this is strictly for the grown and gorgeous. You know what I'm saying? The grown and gorgeous. We got navy blue t-shirts. We got black t-shirts with the matching trucker hats, black and blue. And don't forget, and we got hoodies. What's up?
You know the quality is gonna be top shelf.
Listen, you with these hoodies, you're not gonna get the little boogers, from the lint rolls on your t-shirt. We don't do that over here.
We're not doing that.
All right.
You could wear the hoodie, take the shirt off. Now you got the t-shirt.
Oh my! Who's better than you right now?
No boogies on the t-shirt.
Nobody.
But not for real. You know, we take our time and we do things accordingly. So you're not going to get the little boogies on your t-shirt.
A lot of research.
Take your hoodie off. It's a lot of research.
Hey, yo, y'all peep how the shirt is silky smooth.
Smooth.
Right? And then not only that, but it complements, it contours to your shape.
Yeah. And your sexiness.
Flattering.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? You can wear that. I wear it to the bar now.
I wear it everywhere.
And everybody's like, ooh.
I'm telling you. Right.
Ooh, you sexy.
Now, just wait. Because we about to design some drawers. I'm going to design some crime fighters to wear. You hear me? Go think up the next best thing smoking. You hear me?
You're going to design some patrol underwear?
Patrol drawers. You know what I'm saying? With some socks. The quarters. You know what I mean? It's going to be, you going. I'm telling you, this is just the beginning, baby.
Hey, yo, 5-11, get at us. You need us.
I'm telling you. Everything different, the way we moving. Listen, the wave is different over here.
Hey, Under Armour, I see your tactical department struggling. Come holler.
Come holler.
We'll help you out.
All day, every day.
That's it.
Just cut the check.
All day.
All day.
Because we know you got it.
No, we know you got it. Let me hold something.
You know what I'm saying? We just, you know, we just trying to help people out.
But yeah, we just, you know, we just, listen, we moving at a fast rate. And we enjoy the love. And everybody, please keep tuning in. And by the way, this is episode 38.
38.
It's 38.
Might as well do the recap.
You know what I mean? 38.
You know what I'm saying?
It's we might as well.
I mean, so 30 was a dope episode.
We started off 30 crazy with my brother Braggs.
Yes, he let it off.
I think Braggs was like a tidal wave that nobody saw coming.
I didn't see that coming.
Me neither.
He was a leadoff hitter right there.
What? And his numbers just skyrocket. It continues to grow.
Braggs.
Even currently.
Braggs.
So my boy Braggamuffins is 30.
So like 28, we got T-Real. It was fire. And then, of course, Lieutenant, Her Majesty.
Absolutely.
And then Braggs just put the icing on
top. Just to lead off the 30s.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it just got better.
It did get better.
We interviewed people that played professional sports.
Yeah, yeah. Then 31, Rock came through.
Came through. NY.
Sergeant with the NY. Down. Things got a little emotional.
Supposed to. When
amazing
it's
episode.
Heart.
Touched
the heart.
Amazing
that
was, episode.
Yeah, it was a heartfelt episode.
Yeah, when it's coming from the Corazon,
yeah.
It's the only one way to go, baby.
Yeah, and then 32, right? If y'all see the Instagram, those pictures came from my man Vern.
My man Vern.
Dropped some great knowledge.
AKA the communicator.
What?
Anybody in Maryland needs photo shoot, hit up Vern.
Hit up Vern, we got you.
Hit him up, he'll take care of y'all.
Absolutely.
Speaking about being taken care of.
My brother Papito Albino.
Papito Albino came through with the Kango hat.
What?
Killing
he came through with the Kango hat. I thought it was 1993.
Yeah. I thought he took it back.
He did.
He took it back. He took it back to goddamn.
And I think he was wearing Fahrenheit.
Oh my goodness. Right.
He had on Fahrenheit. Oh, cool.
Wow. What's I think he had a pair of Pepe jeans swords on.
Albino coming through for the next episode. He could be ready.
There's some South Pole boots on.
Yo, Albino was like,
he gonna be locked and loaded.
Albino was like, listen, Papi, when you're out there in shootings, you wear a suit. Here's a flashlight. Boom.
Boom.
I'm like, damn, just the gift that keeps on giving.
Keeps on giving.
He's a sweetheart.
Actually, Albino's doing some work for me right now, his company. First choice is the way to go. I'm gonna put pictures up when he's done. But phenomenal work, phenomenal work, and an even better individual.
Absolutely.
But
absolutely.
Yeah, what else we had?
Oh, speaking of the NFL, DB was here.
Broke it down.
5 years with Minnesota.
Yeah.
Spoke about how important sports was growing up. Your former teammate, right?
Absolutely.
That was brother. Dope.
Right before the season started.
Huh?
So he broke it out right before the season started, too, which was good for a lot of people that listened.
That's right. August 31st. Mm-hmm. Little recap. And in the middle of that, we dropped a mixtape.
First time ever from a podcast. Come to on, ever man. Drop a mixtape. Come on. You got to understand who you're dealing with now, baby.
We got another one coming.
Facts.
Yeah. We're going to work that out.
And then after that, we had my boy Jetta.
Yeah.
My boy Jetta came through.
Mo Better.
He was a former professional boxer. He dropped a jewel on that. Now he's a police officer. So, I mean, you got to understand the people we're bringing on here, man.
That's another athlete, right, who harped and brought it home how important it is to have police, PAL leagues, interactions with the young kids.
You know how big that is, man?
It look, right there, saved
his life.
His life, DBs, right? DB was part of that, right?
Absolutely.
And also 37. And also
your 37 the hitter, Chambers.
Chambers was also in the community.
So we're trying to touch everybody.
And you know what? When you get hit, you got to rebuild, right? You got to rebuild the body. Our phenomenal, you know, physical therapist, Jana, was here.
JB.
She was here. She dropped jewels on how to maintain and...
how to maintain your physique.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Keep you well, you know?
For the professional... what'd she say? What's her saying?
Tactical athletes.
Tactical athletes.
Come on, man. It don't get no better than
no
that.
No better.
Come on, man.
But it's a brief recap, people.
Yeah.
Of the 30s.
That's it.
Listen, we about to jump in the 40s. We on 38.
Yeah, it's going to get crazy. It's going to get crazy.
Just, 1 year anniversary coming up, too.
Yes, it is. Ooh.
That's right.
When was that? November what, 14th?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Stay tuned, y'all. Stay tuned. Stay tuned.
We just want to thank y'all, man. If it wasn't for y'all, we wouldn't be here. Y'all give us so much motivation to keep going and keep, you know, coming back here and just talking and trying to shed the light, this is our little piece of trying to change the world a little bit, you know, and the fact that we have so many people that support us, man, we support y'all.
Right.
It makes this movement that we all like-minded individuals so much stronger.
It is. And real quick, I want to give a heavy shout out to our girl, Sada, out in Cali. She's,
oh, yes.
Just simply amazing.
Yes.
We had a live...
she's such a phenomenal person.
We had an Instagram live interview with her last Sunday.
How'd that go, bro?
It was amazing.
It was dope.
Bro.
Right. It was dope. Real good conversation.
Dope.
Real good. Didn't she play for the WNBA? She was close, right?
Yeah.
Another athlete from Harlem.
Yeah. She played basketball.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, Sada's a beast.
Bro. I want to see a crossover in person.
Well, I want to see a sham guard. I want to see that mid range.
Yeah, word up.
What it look like.
You know what I mean? But we'll arrange that.
Word. Sada, appreciate you, love.
Yes, we do.
And everybody follow her. And we'll upload our interview with her sometime this week. So everybody can peep it, check it out. But let's get into it. Episode 38. Triple C, what we got?
Blocks to badges.
Blocks to badges.
Oh, today we have Atlas. So Atlas 143.
My man.
He wants to know, what are our thoughts on the Breonna Taylor case?
Ay, ay, ay.
Where do we begin?
I mean, we spoke about this and we kind of predicted what was going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Just looking at the case without knowing all the facts. We didn't dive deep into it because a lot of facts weren't released yet. But now that we know... what happened? Mm-hmm. I mean, first and foremost, right? We all agree that it's unfortunate that a female lost her life.
Any person loses their life.
Absolutely.
And, you know, unfortunately, she was an African-American female.
Right.
It's just...
it's a lot that went on.
It's so much to that case. But I want people to understand the facts, man. Police ain't just run up in her apartment. They had a signed warrant, a no-knock warrant to be served at her address. If you have a signed no-knock warrant, that's what it is. It's a no-knock. You got enough justification to get through that door without saying nothing. And when you get inside that door, that's when you announce your presence. Police, police, police. Search warrant.
Right. People are confused. They think that because there was no announcement, they're just walking around the house in like in the cover of darkness. That is that's not true. You hit the door and then you announce yourself, police, 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 police. Now, I believe he said he only heard it once, but the other five, six times they said police, mm-hmm. He was sleeping.
Listen, the reason there's a no-knock warrant because it eliminates the surprise. We want you to be there, and the surprise is gone. Yeah, we want you to be asleep. Because to get that signed for a no-knock warrant, the likelihood of something being in that place is paramount. That's why I was signed. So you can go in there and handle your business. Now, if you go in there and you announce yourself, police, police, and there's rounds being shot at you, okay, now you're a police officer. So what do we have to do? There's a threat in there. And what do we have to do? Eliminate that threat and stop it.
Because I have the legal right to be here.
Of course. It was signed by a judge. I just don't understand. Like,
I mean, the problem now is that everybody's so emotional. They're not looking at the facts.
They're not.
You have to look first. I mean, all right. First of all, you have to be educated on this topic. You have to understand law.
Yes.
It ain't just, oh, my cousin, you know, they hit his house before and this is what happened. Oh, they ain't do God. That. No,
don't you get tired of hearing that, bro?
Yeah. It doesn't work that way.
And could you all explain to them like the totality? So even before we got to the no-knock warrant, the surveillance that was done, and then the conjunction of two other warrants that were trying to be served at the exact same time to try to take who they felt was a known drug dealer or drug, quote, kingpin off of the streets. Can you all kind of break down, just in general, how that goes to do from surveillance on to you before you get up to the actual serving of a no-knock warrant?
When there's a high priority warrant like that, well, with high priority, I think SWAT hits that. Mm-hmm. If it's right under high priority and a drug unit is doing it, or a narcotics unit is doing it, mm-hmm. they have eyes on that house for 24 hours before they do anything.
Tell them.
See who's coming in and out, what they're coming in and out with. Okay, so there's a terminology where, like, the house wasn't fat, so which means that the house didn't have that work in it at that moment. But they had enough probable cause that the judge sufficed, or the judge believed that there was enough in there for them to get a no-knock, because there's either drugs, guns, or both in that residence. So it just so happened that there was nothing there. But what happens with drugs and guns? It gets moved constantly. Mm-hmm. Everybody knows that. Drugs and guns never stay in one location for too long, because these people that are playing this game, they know that we're watching. So it's like cat and mouse.
That's what it is.
You got to move it from one location to the next. I mean, her address popped up multiple times, right? Several times.
Yep.
And, you know, a drug dealer's car came to the back to that. All these things. So they had enough. Again, sad that the way it turned out, very misfortunate. But
I mean, no officer goes inside that situation and says, I'm going to shoot this black woman that's unarmed. Like,
First of all, we don't even know what's behind that door.
No. What face? We're trying to get to the unknown and turn it to a known. We don't know what's behind that door. Nothing.
People need to understand, like, especially narcotics cops, that they're just chasing drugs and guns, right? But the drugs and guns just so happen to be attached to a person. Like, we'll be happy if we ran into a room and it was a room full of guns and drugs, and we'll be happy with that.
Absolutely.
So it's not about, oh my God, we're running in there, we're killing people. No, we're trying to take the drugs and guns off the streets.
Absolutely.
It just so happens that somebody, right, there's always an individual that has to watch the guns and the drugs, because somebody paid a lot of money for those two items.
Sure did.
So you have to protect that until it's going to the next location. And if you're there protecting it, there's a chance you're going to go to jail.
You're going to get booked for it.
Or you might, unfortunately, if you shoot at police, you're going to be neutralized.
Yeah.
I don't understand. I forgot who I was talking to. It's like, everyone loves chicken, right? Everyone loves steak. But nobody really wants to see how that chicken or steak gets to your plate. It's the same thing like criminals, right? Mm-hmm. Everybody wants crime to come down. Everybody wants a safe street. Everybody wants guns off the streets. Everybody wants drugs out of their neighborhood. But nobody understands the process of how to catch and get those guns and drugs off, out of your communities. It's not going to be pretty.
No.
Killing a cow for your steak, your prime rib, your filet
mignon.
Right? Because it's beautiful on the plate.
Right.
But the process with that butcher, nobody wants to see that.
At all.
It's the same thing with police work. It's the same thing with firefighters. It's the same thing with EMT. People are not, like, you don't want to see that EMT worker pumping on that person's chest because he just got shot. And he's trying their best as they're driving to the hospital, trying their best to revive that person. And then hopefully they get to the hospital, that person lives. Nobody saw that. Everybody just see, oh, you know, he got shot, but he lived. But they don't understand that there are trained professionals there with blood on their hands that doesn't belong to them. They don't care if the person is white, black, Asian, Dominican, Puerto Rican, Cuban. They don't care about that. They're there to save a life. Same thing like narcotics people. They're there to remove drugs and guns off the streets. That process is ugly. People are going to get hurt.
There's nothing cute about it.
Right. That's why only a certain amount of people can do the first responder job.
Yeah.
You know, like I can't be a fireman because I fire me and seeing a, I've seen burned bodies. That's not for me. So I'm not going down that path. Shout out to those firefighters that they see that. They see that and they come home and it's crazy. So it's the same thing. Like, we're chasing criminals. People want the happy results. Oh, you got guns off the streets. But sometimes somebody's going to get touched, especially if they don't want to go willingly.
If they play that game, there's only going to be one outcome.
Yeah.
It's only going to be what? Listen, it ain't rocket science. You comply, that's what we want you to do.
Yeah.
Put the gun down. Let me see your hands. That's it.
We always want y'all to comply because nobody's trying to fight.
Hell no. You know, ain't nobody trying to fight.
Dudes, they're in their 40s, 50s, whatever. Ain't nobody trying to get scrap.
Come on.
Come on, man. Just, you know you're in the wrong. Just face it.
Use a man playing this game. You got caught. Be a man. Take your time. That's it.
You know what I've noticed? It's the new drug dealers. Because the old drug dealers, they treated this as a business. And they knew if the block was hot, stop making it hot. I mean, yeah. We're conducting business, right? And they also knew, remember that dude when we were
on the west side?
Yeah, on post riots.
Yeah.
We that on dude the,
yeah.
Who ran the whole thing?
He was chopping it up with us.
He was like, listen, fellas, y'all know what I'm doing. I know what you're doing.
He said, listen, I'll be honest with you. I got two bags of weed. And I said, listen, we ain't here for all that, fam.
Yeah. He said, I don't want no problems. He was like, what time y'all get off? We were like, I think 10.
10 or 11.
He was like, bet. He did a little whistle. The block cleared out. He said, I ain't messing with y'all. He told her, I'll get money when y'all leave.
Absolutely.
I was like, God damn.
And you know what made that conversation so deep and thorough? Because he was talking to real, it was all grown men having a conversation.
That's it. It wasn't, oh, we're cops and you're the drug dealer. Nah. It was just men feeding their families.
That's it.
Unfortunately. If you bring it down to the bare bones of it, that's exactly what's happening. And he was black.
Yep.
I mean, we're minorities as well, right? But we understood something. He understood, if I mess with y'all, there's a chance that I'm going to go to jail and I'm going to lose a lot of money today. Or my crew is going to lose money today. You know what? Let's put the game on pause.
That's it.
Y'all have a good day. And when y'all leave, business is back to usual.
Absolutely.
The old heads understand that. They understand it. The new heads, they want to fight. They want to kick. They want to scream. Fam, you're in the wrong. That dude, he knew he was in the wrong, but it was kind of like his way to like mitigate it. Like, hey, I know what y'all doing. You know what I'm doing.
I know what it is.
I'm going to get out of y'all way.
Absolutely.
I'm going to go take my lady out to lunch. I think that's what he said. Sound like that.
He said something like that. But he walked with us for like two blocks.
Yeah.
Chilling. We was all just talking, and chopping it up.
And the young kids were looking at him like he was like, crazy.
Yo, what you doing?
And he was like, I dare you to say something.
Right.
Because the young kids, they don't understand that. We have to coexist no matter what.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Good and evil, we have to coexist.
It's yin and yang.
Yeah, these young boys, they just talk. All they is just talk.
Talk.
To me, they talking barbecue sauce at a horse's race. Ain't saying shit.
Sure, you weren't a pimp in your former life. Yeah, you got this. You got our words, son. We got to do facial recognition. But Ace, yo, you going to see a dude with a big hat. Like, yo, I'm like, that's Ace, son.
Oh, chilling. A leather overcoat.
Yeah, baby, word. Let me tell you something. When you spit it, you got to spit it and get it, baby.
But the God be spitting, yo.
Yeah, the God definitely be spitting.
You know, come with the God.
All right.
But what else we got, bro?
So we got something else from BSC, the Full Send Motor.
Yeah.
He wants to know, how in the hell hasn't Shook Ones Part 2 made a damn mixtape?
Got you on the next one, Papi.
Yeah, we got the next one, bro.
Yeah, dope song.
Come on, man. We rep Mobb Deep all day.
Hell yeah.
No, rest in peace to Prodigy all day. And Havoc's still a monster out there. That's old school right there.
I think I told him.
Like, yo, how the hell this song didn't make it on there? And I'm like, yo, we only had 10 songs to pick from.
That's all.
I think I held a few songs off because I didn't want y'all running through the walls because y'all was telling me some of these songs got y'all in game mode. So I had to make sure I had to calm it down.
Yo, I was listening to it the other day and I almost put the TRD in a wall.
You're funny.
I was so hyped.
I listened to that joint when I was at the gym the other day.
How you felt?
It felt great. When I hit Ghost Gym, it just feels amazing.
Oh, you go to Ghost?
Yeah. I had to go back because I go with DB now. You know what I mean? So we try to get you swole. Yeah.
I wonder why you looking nice and fit in the t-shirt. And trying to go Fati shirt.
You know what I'm saying? Try to go first thing 5 in the morning.
Okay.
Ooh. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Pulling the brakes.
Get a nice little burn.
Get that metabolism up and running.
Absolutely.
Early.
First and foremost. I put it on. I swear the whole workout, it was the whole workout. From your part, your side and my side, that's a whole hour and some change.
Yeah.
Dope. And I was done.
Yeah.
And it felt, because it was nonstop. Nonstop. And it felt good, man.
And to Albino, you could F you because my side is not for old men.
Oh, wow.
just because I asked for a little Sinatra. He was cursing me out like, Papi, your side is for old people, bro. You got to
break it down. He broke it down off camera, yo, but let people know like how y'all used to when we used to come in and he used to just pick with you all the time. He'd be like, yo, what you doing? So like, yo, for a whole hour before the show started, it was like both of them being in the same district again had us in tears.
Who Albino and I?
Yeah.
Well, because his office, he had a very nice office, I must say. Like Albino, he's from Boston, right?
Yeah.
So he had nothing but
we ain't gonna say that too much, but yeah.
Tom Brady, Red Sox, the Pops,
yeah,
and like the bobbleheads, placards, rings, the whole thing.
He went overboard.
So I would go in there and just tip his, a Tom Brady, portrait? What's the
I love you, Tom Brady, with some Uggs on.
Right. I'll Albino's so meticulous, like everything has to be perfect. I will go in there and like he'll be like, Papi, hold on, I'll be right back. I'm gonna go do something and I will fuck his office up. And like I would make the frame just tilt like an inch. He'll come back and be like, what the fuck, bro? You messing with my frame? And I'm like, nah, bro. I mean, it's ugly. You should just take it down.
Right.
Yeah.
That's dope.
Yeah. But yeah, so yeah, we'll have another mixtape coming, bro. We got you. But we never forget Mobb Deep.
Maybe do something like for I don't know what's coming up, Halloween.
We'll
do something scary.
We'll do something.
It's gonna get spooky outside.
We'll do a Halloween mixtape, and then we'll do Christmas for all you.
Yeah,
Christmas lovers. I love Christmas.
Yeah, me too.
You know what I'm saying,
throw some Mariah Carey on there.
Absolutely. She still kills that song though.
Of course.
Amazing.
Of course. I think of Christmas. That's one of the
Christmas in you.
Shout out to Mariah. I would have never done you like Nick did, but whatever.
Oh my god.
You know what I'm saying? I would have done that. The guy wears like what's that thing he wears? A
don't
turban.
Do that. Just stop it.
Alright, I'm gonna shut up. It. He works out though, so I'm scared.
Oh my god. Next question, Chris.
Yeah. This from Eric Lopez 180.
Elo.
Why good cops don't put a stop to bad cops. Exact quote.
I can't speak for any other officer.
Right.
I could just speak on how me and my squad conduct ourselves.
Right.
If we saw a bad officer, it was the last day he did anything bad. Or that last moment he did anything bad. Because we nipped that shit in the butt ASAP. That's not how we operate. And you shouldn't be here at all. Because I really can't get into detail after that. But just saying, we hands on. But it never happened again.
I mean, p- police officers, I believe, they do stop that. They do. It's the TV, it's the movies that they go. You know how many checks and balances are when you're a police officer? We have cameras. You have multiple eyes on us.
Even more so now.
Yeah. Like, if you're doing something shady, I know, like, if I allowed it. For example, I had once upon a time, somebody said something to a female officer that was very inappropriate. And it was just like a comment. He was corny and he said something stupid.
Wow.
And I defended her. And he was looking at me like I was crazy. Like,
I remember you
bro,
told me about
bro,
that.
Like, bro, I thought we were on the same side. No, fam. Because when she writes you up, she's going to also say that I was there and I did nothing. And I can't be suspended because you're talking crazy. And this is like on a light scale situation. He was mm-hmm. just trying to hit on her. Right. But it was very corny about it. It was very inappropriate.
Right.
And I said, whoa, buddy, you can't talk like that in front of me. Right. Chill out. He got mad at me because he thought it was like, yo, we're both men. She looks good. Like, you should be backing me. No, Poppy.
That's not how we operate,
I'm not going to back you because that was way out of line. And if she puts me in with you, now my family can't eat.
Absolutely. Because you're just as guilty.
Yeah, you're just as guilty. So I wouldn't necessarily say that we don't do that because it does happen.
Absolutely.
But also, it's the same question, Elo. How come the community doesn't give up the shooters when the shooters are doing shootings?
Absolutely.
It's the same thing.
Same thing, bro.
We weren't there. We want the community to speak. You're not snitching.
Help us out.
We want to solve a crime in your community.
You taxpaying citizens, help out, baby.
Point the way. Just, you know what I'm saying? You know what Give I'm me saying? A little wink. What happened?
Right. That's
it's the same thing.
Blow me a kiss, something, baby.
Just
you know what I'm saying? Look, right
over
there.
You ever thought about that? You ever thought about that? I mean, like, everything right now is the police is the problem. It's like the crime, right? The crime, we're not the ones committing the crime. And when we're investigating, no one's saying anything.
No. And we're left to put the pieces together.
So y'all want us to, all right, I get it. You want us to, you know, bring the bad cops forward. How about you bring the real bad guys
forward?
Yeah, bring them forward as well. Let's do it, right? Y'all want transparency, right? We're being transparent. Now it's your turn in the community. You saw the shooting. You saw what he looked like. Come forward.
Yeah, come help out, man. But
and that's it.
Yeah, like for us, you know, we don't deal with officers, you know, that are bad at all. That's not what we stand for. That's not what we came on the job for.
No.
So we turn those guys in and we get rid of them because they're not needed at all.
And plus, it takes food off our table.
Absolutely.
Because I allowed that to happen.
And it never happened. In my book.
And listen to Her Majesty's episode, who is
a lieutenant.
A lieutenant. Yeah. That absolutely said, I don't know where you got that from because they come to me with everything.
Everything.
So that supports what, you know, we've been talking about. And for me, like I've said a million times growing up around Baltimore City cops that were like first generation back in the 80s, like it's not true. Most police officers, from what they told me, report other police officers. It's just, I don't know where that stat is, but this has been told to me from generation, even to my guys right here. And these are people that I knew that were aunts and uncles to me in the 80s. So,
and I
think that's something that the community made up, and I just don't know where the stats.
It comes from like good drama on TV.
Yeah,
that's
where
it comes from.
But yeah, definitely listen to the episode with Her Majesty. I forgot. I can't shoot from the hip. What episode is that?
It was
I want to say 29.
29.
Good job.
29, man. Because she also talks about in-house discipline.
Ooh,
which is paramount.
Mm.
So when I say she's a phenomenal lieutenant, yo, listen to the episode, bro. But thanks for the question, definitely. What else we got, bro?
The last one is from Atlas 143. What are some of the laws or what are some of the case laws that you all look into?
I would say, I don't know where you're from, bro, but a perfect foundation for overall any department. A reference to officers utilizing use of force. The court case is Graham versus Connor that establishes objective reasonableness in reference to utilizing and using use of force. How it all came about. That's the court case. You can actually look it up on YouTube. It's a nice little cartoon, but it gives you the case law, what happened, and why the use of force came about in reference to policing. But Graham versus Connor, you can look that up on YouTube. There's a nice little cartoon video about it, and it gives you everything you need to know about it and how police officers utilize it in reference to modern day policing today.
For me, I'll go with Payton versus New York because it explains for all those people that got their street corner degrees. If you got your degree from the corner, if you got your degree from the corner of Kingsbridge and Jerome,
word,
this is for you. You know that phone that
yo, I'm telling you, man, you can't take him on that charge, man. Telling you, you know what I'm saying? I made that shit the other day. You know, man, back in cereal box.
Remember we used to be like, oh, you got your degree from the corner, the Pennsylvania North University.
Word.
Have you ever pulled anybody up? Was like, I'm a sovereign citizen. You'd be like,
oh hell yeah,
yo,
I appreciate you.
Right,
I got a couple.
But you're gonna go to this American jail though.
Right.
Oh yeah.
Let's appreciate you being sovereign, but check it out.
Yeah, on the state
still getting the fuck out the car. Let's go.
Come on. I got a couple. Yo, those people are dangerous.
You gotta
though.
You gotta come to America. Yeah, you come though. To American. Yeah, you gotta go to the American jail though.
Yeah.
They don't have no sovereign jails in the U.S.
Yeah, I like H side. I don't know what state you're in, but like a federal case. Payton versus New York, and they talk about your Fourth Amendment, right, as far as search warrants and, you know, crossing that threshold. Yeah. I believe any person that does the job should know what Payton versus New York is, because when it comes to writing search warrants for a home, this right here will be the one that, you know, will keep you out of the jackpot, as they say.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes.
Gotta know what you're doing, baby.
So, was it Connor versus who?
No, Graham versus Connor.
Graham versus Connor?
Yeah.
And Payton versus the NY.
There you go.
Read up on that. And that's it.
That'll give you a nice, strong foundation of those two things.
Yeah, like people need to stop listening. Oh, my cousin, you know, he got locked up. And and his lawyer said, no. Go to the actual law. Go to the actual case law. And there you will find your truth.
Which is crazy these days, because even
that was
with
back in 1980, look,
even with a case like what's going on with the with the quote Breonna Taylor case,
it's just hard
to find just the facts, because everybody, like, it seems like whatever news outlet they have their opinion already into it. So, like, for us. Like, for people that don't understand, like even for them when they became officers, and even before then, for me before then, even when I, you know, started moving up the judicial ranks, whatever, that's the biggest thing they told us. Now, we came in pre-internet, so, like, trying to look for facts is something that we were always told with the card catalog and libraries and stuff. So,
right.
You just want the facts of what's going on, and then you make your own determinations. The biggest thing I'll try to tell everybody out there, citizens, I know 99% of police officers know this, but I need 99% of the citizens to understand. Try to find something that absolutely positively gives you just the facts, and then you make your own decision.
I agree.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we can't just stick to Fox. We can't just stick to CNN. You have to find a credible resource and read it, right? Never mind what your aunt said or what your neighbor said. Read it and make your own determination. Read between the lines before you go out there and be all emotional and, you know, rah, 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 you know.
Facts. So that was it for
Blacks to Badges.
Blacks to Badges. We are in the Silverback News. And this is from PoliceOne.com. NYPD. That's dope, too.
I love that one.
NYPD should stop making traffic stops.
Who said that?
The Attorney General, Lytia James.
What's her name?
Lytia James.
I bet she's never done a traffic stop.
New York's Attorney General on Friday recommended that NYPD get out of the business of routine traffic enforcement. A radical change, she said, would prevent encounters like one last year in the Bronx that escalated quickly and ended with an officer fatally shooting a motorist.
Escalated quickly, why?
Attorney General Lydia James, who acts as a special prosecutor, was appointed to investigate certain police killings, argued that traffic stops for minor infractions often ended in violence, and Alan Felice's death last October after he was pulled over for a seatbelt violation further underscored the need for the charge.
So,
but, big but.
Go ahead.
Felice initially complied with the officers, and he got out of the car. But it also says that he had outstanding warrants with an S.
That's more than one.
That's more than one. Mm-hmm. Okay.
The NYPD declined to comment.
For low-level offenses such as spitting, littering, disorderly conduct. So he was a little hothead.
Right.
So they're not going to comment?
So here's the thing, please, right? If she doesn't want us to enforce seatbelt violations, then don't make it illegal to ride without a seatbelt.
Yeah, let them do what they want to do.
And if they crash and they get ejected out of the car, just chalk it up as a loss.
So be it.
It's that simple. Yo, we used to stop cars all the time. Hey, man, wear your seatbelt. I don't like wearing seatbelts. Okay, so when you wrap yourself around that pole, we're just going to come up, write the report as a fatal accident, and be on our way.
Yeah.
I know on this podcast, I'm very... like blunt and like, you know, H is way smoother, but it's the truth. Like, that is what it is. You don't wear your seatbelt, you crash, we're gonna show up, we're gonna scrape you off the ground, we're gonna write the report, what time it was, what color was your vehicle, the plate, the facts, right? Because the insurance company is gonna need that. And then we're on to our next call.
Yeah.
So if she doesn't like police officers pulling people over for a seatbelt or minor infractions, then, ma'am, change the law. And you won't have police officers doing that.
But it kills me because it's a minor infraction. Yes, it is. It's a seatbelt. But the individual had open warrants. So investigations lead to different things.
Exactly.
And if it's a minor infraction, then okay, it should be no big deal. But my man, you got open warrants. You shouldn't even be out here right now.
Why did it escalate? Because he didn't want to go to jail.
Because he didn't want to go to jail.
Because he had open warrants.
He didn't want to go to jail.
That's it.
So it's all about the individual. It's not us.
And now here's the bigger thing, Miss. What's her name?
It is Lydia
James.
Miss James. I don't know where you live.
AG.
I'm sure you went to a school for a long time. But because while you were in school, there was a lot of hard men and women working these streets, right? To make the streets safe while you went to school. Ma'am, how does drugs and guns get transported from place to place?
Yeah, how about that?
It's not on a bike. I mean, some do get on bikes.
But besides boats, how else are they being transported?
How does a large amount of drugs go from point A to point B?
And guns.
In and out of communities all day.
Every day.
How do they move around? Because they certainly don't have legs, ma'am. How do they move around, ma'am? Oh, in vehicles.
Vehicles.
Oh, with people that, right? Minor infractions, right? Maybe his taillight is out. And you notice that his taillight is out because that is against the law to drive around with a taillight that does not work. And that police officer makes a traffic stop, right? And that person who's moving drugs and guns, their heart is beating through their chest. You asking them, sir, you have a license or registration? Huh? Huh? Sir.
Why are you so nervous? What's going on?
Calm down, sir. Calm down. Oh, ma'am. Calm down. I'm just pulling you over because your taillight is out.
That's it.
Yeah. You know.
Sir, you okay? What's going on?
Why are you so sweaty?
Yeah. Do you have a valid license?
Why are you nervous? Why are your hands shaking?
Right.
These are all tells that are going through your head. Sir, it's just a taillight.
Right.
Relax. And then you're like, wait a minute. It's not just a taillight.
No.
This car is fat. This car. Can we get a backup unit, please?
Yes, can I get a 1016 to my location, please? So I can further this investigation.
Yeah.
How about that?
Sir, would you mind?
Sir, no. Oh, you don't have a license.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay.
So wait, you're driving in a car that doesn't have your taillights off.
Right.
Don't work, and you don't have a license.
Don't have a license.
And you're super nervous.
And your heart's beating through your chest. You're sweating profusely.
Here's the golden question. Sir, is there anything in this vehicle that I need to know about? Any bazookas, guns, drugs, anything in this car? You know what's the answer? I don't know.
Oh.
Wait a minute. You're driving a car and you don't know what's in it? Well, if that's the case, sir, would you please step out? I'll check. Because I don't know what's in there that might harm me or my partners.
Absolutely.
And an incident.
It happens. They get nervous.
You got a brick in the trunk and a burner in your lap.
How about that?
Wow. But according to Ms. James, we let that go. Go ahead.
Knock yourself out.
Like, New York City doesn't have enough problem as it is.
Right. Listen, I could play any game. Just let me know the rules to it, baby.
Yeah, we could do whatever you want, man. Just, if you don't, change the law.
That's it.
Because we don't write laws. We enforce them.
That's it.
But shout out to that court that put all those warrants on them and let them out and never did nothing with them.
I can't wait till we get a state trooper. One of my guys that I work with right now, all of his... Everything he started with was exactly what y'all said.
State troopers.
And it was literally a coordination with you all and them. And he gave me 10 straight stories, and all of them were major drug dealers.
Yeah.
Based on the exact same thing that y'all said.
Look, right?
Same scenario. Some of them ended in shootouts.
So look, right? Real simple. Just to give you a quick. How do drugs get into the United States? Through which ports? Towards the south. And some through the Canadian border. But majority of the drugs come in through the south. Texas, California, Arizona, mm-hmm. Florida, right? Now, let's just say two major cities, right? If the drugs, let's just say two states. If drugs come in through Texas and Florida, right? Two major hubs. Because Texas is like the hub for the West Coast and central United States. And Florida, is the East Coast. How does the drugs get from Florida and Texas to L.A. and New York City? They weren't walking. It came in a vehicle.
Sure did. Put some miles out there.
So, yeah. It gets real sophisticated. Some people get on the Greyhound or Megabus or whatever you want to call it. Some people drive.
Yeah.
Some people take the Amtrak. But a lot of it comes through those cars.
Telling you,
she clearly. I'm no disrespect to her. I'm sure she's a smart woman, but she does. She's stepping in an arena that she has no business in.
But just have a conversation.
She's stepping.
Ride with y'all for
which
a
is
week.
Cool. But she's an attorney general. Whoa, all these great law, blah blah blah. But she's never done this aspect of law.
Hey, everything comes in a car stop.
Everything.
Is in the car stop.
Everything. Think about what's in your car right now. You got mail. Because you're a good guy, right? You got mail. You got a basketball. You got football. Because that's what you're into. Now, if you play the criminal game, what's in there? You got guns. You got knives. You got stuff to protect your product.
Yeah.
You got stuff to, if you a sticker boy, you got ski mask.
Yeah.
You got gloves. You got tools of the trade. If you're a plumber, what do you have? You got cork. You know what I'm saying?
You got hammers.
Yeah.
Yo, it's
It's all in the vehicle, bro.
And this and don't let me smell weed. Is there anything else in the vehicle I need to know about? No.
Are you sure?
I got reasonable articular suspicion to check the vehicle. And that means I'm checking everything.
Off the scent.
Off the scent alone, I can check every part of that vehicle. And his person, that's everything in that car.
You shouldn't even be driving smoking.
At all.
So you're already in the wrong.
I just don't get these modern day lawyers that get pulled over. No, you can't look at my car. You can't. Sir.
Ma'am.
Come on.
Come on, stop it.
Stop it. But yeah, bro, everything comes in the car stop, I'm telling you.
Crime is up. I don't know how, what's the percentage. I don't want to say it because then I'm wrong. But crime is definitely up in New York City. It's been documented. And by them just proposing something so, like she said, radical. If you want crime to go through the roof, if you want, people are already leaving New York City. It's been documented. People are leaving New York City. I read an article today because I'm into real estate. 15,000 high-end apartments, lofts, penthouses are vacant because these people with money are leaving New York City.
Yeah.
Because of ridiculous laws like such, or proposals, or whatever you want to call that. Absolutely asinine.
Safety and education. Asinine. Always be the top priorities.
Yeah. Oh. Let's stop doing car stops because they're petty, man. Do you know what comes in a car, man?
Hell yeah.
Do a ride along, sweetheart.
Come on, man.
Do a ride along.
What else we got, Chris?
Don't stop stopping people where I live.
That's like me trying to. That's like me trying to. Trying to.
Just don't stop. Jeez. Man, I wish they would.
Don't do it.
I love my safety.
Right.
Serious.
That's like us trying right now to hold a criminal case. I wouldn't know where to begin.
What?
But I'm not gonna say it. Yeah, I could do it. No, I'm gonna sit here and mind my business and let lawyers handle it.
Absolutely.
If you're a lawyer, do lawyer things. Leave the police work to police officers.
We got these two, but this one story right here is just the one. This is the
cake, bro.
Oh my
this,
god!
This is where we're gonna end off the banquet.
Yeah,
read it to us, baby.
Shout out to FoxNews.com.
When was it published?
FoxNews.com.
The last 2 hours.
2 hours ago.
Today.
And shout out who put the what do you call it, the just the on the front what is the that title. Called?
Title.
Yeah.
Is it like the grabber? Like that's what
yeah,
grabs
because
the headline?
You can tell they down with it. You can tell it down. Atlanta activist spent 200,000 G in Black Lives Matter donation on house. Personal expenses from the FBI.
Are you kidding me?
His name is Sir Major Page.
Wow.
32 is facing fraud and money laundering charges. Okay. The FBI has arrested the founder of a Black Lives Matter group in Atlanta on fraud and money laundering charges. Sir Major Page, 32, was accused Friday of misappropriating $200,000 in donations he solicited through Facebook on behalf of Black Lives Matter of the Greater Atlanta, and Fox 5 reported. Page was arrested in Toledo, released on bond, and before a judge via video, he did not immediately return the message.
I bet he did.
Let's see what he got with that.
I just realized he was arrested in Toledo, but he's from Atlanta.
Yeah. This year.
What is he doing in Toledo?
And more than $466,000 in donations in June, July, and August. He spent $200 on personal items generated from donations.
Gucci.
And then he said, this is for social justice. That's what he said. For racial justice.
Racial justice.
Okay. And what does racial justice cost for the donations? It costs food, dining, entertainment, clothing, furniture, home security.
Okay. Gotta stay safe.
Yeah. Even though you want to defund, home security though.
Right.
I know. Yeah.
Tailor suits, because you got to look good when you're going out to protest.
Right.
Look good.
And accessories. You can't just walk out. You got to have accessories.
You got to have the iPhone 11 Max Pro with the matching iPad.
And just in case I got to, like, get back and forth to, like, the Midwest.
Right.
I bought a house there, too, for $112.
Oh, what'd he get?
Oh, that's why he was in Toledo?
Money purchase. Money. Oh, money.
Oh, he spent $112,000?
On a house. Because, you know, because I got a case, I got a protest in Ohio, Michigan.
Oh, my God.
That's the Black Lives Matter house in Ohio. That's why.
Yeah.
Look at this schlep.
And on top of that, he's an albino.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh my god.
Yo, it's comedy hour for this Black Lives movement, man.
It is, because this guy clearly exploited
the black people.
Yeah.
His own people.
Yeah.
Wow.
I mean, if he's even white.
Like,
I mean, black, but
do you see this comedy hour right here?
Wait, how much did he make off the George Floyd donations?
466,000.
In 3 months.
466,000.
Easy.
Wow.
Easy.
And took 200 of it.
Just skim it a little bit off the top.
You know?
Just skim a little off the top.
He said, yeah, let's defund the police. Let's tear that shit up. And by the way, before you leave, let me get that donation. I'm going to need that money.
I'm gonna need that money.
Yeah.
I heard Gucci's dropping polos with the right. snake on the collar.
Yeah, don't forget to drop that. And yo, you see, yo, I just had a phenomenal meeting. I took $116 down and put and bought me a brand new album, motherfucking Toledo. Damn. Killing him.
Bald.
That motherfucker, he Reverend Leon Love from Martin, son.
That dude, yeah. Not Reverend Love, yeah, that's my dude, yo.
Can't forget about Reverend Love.
Like, do you see this? People just taking advantage of the movement and just doing their own thing.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Took money from black people.
How about that?
But went and bought himself a crib. And all these fine entertainment. What is entertainment? That means strip clubs.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm thinking the same thing.
Fam, you ain't going to no play.
No.
You're not going to Broadway to watch Cats.
That's a donation.
Probably, but right.
You're not going to see Cats, bro.
Right. It's not going to happen.
No Hamilton for you, fam.
No Hamilton,
I don't know what you
fam.
Was doing. Why? Entertainment.
Does he get to write that off?
He probably did.
Charity.
And you know what's crazy is that the feds got him.
Yeah, that's feds, different.
So, you know, that slam dunk case right there. It's over.
It's different.
Man. How come there's no police hate towards us?
That's different.
I mean, here we got a strong albino who manipulated the minds of black people in the name of a poor dead person.
Were in George Greater Ford, Atlanta.
And went and cop a house. Why Toledo?
I don't know.
Anyway, man.
He probably from out there.
He looks like
he looked like you from out there.
Just want to move back and forth.
Major Pain, Page.
A lot of stuff going on in you know in Middle America right now. He wanted to make sure he was you know out there with the people.
You know he's bugging
people. Like this is a legit story. Please stop letting yourselves. The media, people like this are opportunists. They're gonna play on your emotions.
And his real name is what? Tyree Connors.
His name is Tyree.
Connors Page. Wow.
An albino.
With a perm.
He has a red perm.
You know what I'm saying? Looking like Big Red from the Five Heartbeats.
He's a ginger. Son. He's a ginger.
Right.
I
wouldn't give him a pound, son.
I would never give this guy a high five.
Word.
I would just head nod. I'm like, yo.
Yo.
I'm going this way. I'm sorry.
Yeah, he definitely looks shady.
Shady as hell.
Oh, look at this dude.
And then he puts on the Malcolm X glasses on.
Come on, B. With the black perm. Come on, fam.
At least dye your hair black, right?
Yo, he's bugging.
He's bugging.
The whole movement be bugging out, bro. Yeah,
he stole from his own people.
His own people. Look at that. In a few months, made $466,000. Took $200,000. Easy.
3 months.
Let's defund these guys. By the way, listen. Deposit that $200 down now. Check with me.
Can you cash out?
Yeah, I'm gonna need that shit. Right?
We need to buy more signs.
Yeah. Right. No checks. Right. Okay.
We gotta go to Lowe's and buy more plywood for the signs.
Right.
Yes.
Come on, man.
That's ridiculous.
Just I'm over it already. I'm over it.
That's it for news.
I think that might be it for everything.
Word. But y'all, it's episode 38.
Yeah.
It's phenomenal.
Quick recap. It's just us and y'all. It's us and y'all.
It's us and y'all.
Y'all with us.
You're the we, yang to we our yang. Y'all.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You with us. We with y'all. And it's they all, with us.
It's all love. Every week.
Yeah.
Gonna please keep people. Giving you that.
Please, people, before we react, check your emotions.
Breathe.
Do your homework.
Yes.
Before you go out there and start pounding pavements and, you know, start talking about stuff you don't know. Social dilemma, right? Social dilemma? Check out social dilemma. Our phones are a la carte. These messages, these apps, they send us something. So, like, if H, let's say H likes Nike and I like Reebok. His phone is going to... No, that's a bad example.
It's all good, but
that's a good
one. No. What I'm saying is that everyone's phone or whatever way we get news, it's been documented from the early developers of these phenomenal apps like Facebook, Twitter. They curate it to what you want to see. That's why no one knows what they're talking about right now, because there's no truth. Like, your truth is different from my truth because it's curated to what you want to see so that the advertisers
can send you.
Can send you
to make money.
Make money.
People, just take a breath, sit back.
Yes.
If you hear a story that's crazy, I mean, just crazy. Did he do that? You know what? Let me take a second. Let me do some research just to make sure I have all of the facts before I just start jumping on the bandwagon. Because we love you. We appreciate you. And that's why this platform was made for us. To give you the truth. We're the real ones. The good guys. Silverbacks. But
I don't even want to interrupt that. That was amazing.
Right. Hey, appreciate you, bro. But with that being said, my people, it's episode 38. We appreciate you. We got a second wave merchandise coming out in about another, what, 2 weeks, Dre?
Yeah.
Ballpark in 2 weeks.
Maybe a week and a half, yeah. Hats, maybe. Trucker hats, navy and black. Matching shirts. The material on the black shirt is the same material as the navy shirt. That tri-blend. Ooh. Phenomenal for the skin.
Phenomenal.
Silky smooth.
You add some cocoa butter to that? Oh, God.
When you do delts, it accentuates.
What?
Accentuates. Ooh. There you go.
But listen.
And then the hoodie, when it gets a little nippy. Oof. Throw that on top. Ugh. Nobody knows what you do for a living.
And you add some Razak to that?
Some what?
Razak. It's that old school lotion, so.
Yeah.
Yeah,
put that in your bag.
And forget about it. Once she get a scent of you, it's over. You could cancel Christmas.
Yo, we might even create a cologne with Albino. It's going to be a cross of like 1997 Cool Water. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
With a little bit of splash of her Fahrenheit.
Right. And some of that Sean John, but you know what I'm saying? We call it Sean James. And,
hey, LeBron, if you're listening, come talk to us.
Yeah, let's have a convo, bro.
We'll help you out.
We appreciate you. All right, everybody.
We got some fights to go watch.
Absolutely. It's about that time. So we love you. Be safe. You know, don't drink and drive. Uber's right around the corner. And we'll see you next week.
Adios.
Adios, chicas and chicos.
The views and opinions expressed on the Silverback Podcast are those of the hosts, producers, and or the persons appearing on the program, and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the federal, state, or local government. This includes, but not exclusive to, the Department of Defense and or the Baltimore City Police Department.